vestige.
Wait, did that lost leave something behind?
This is Mr. Mido. He's going to be taking all of you in.
I don't think we'll get along with him. He doesn't look like he smiles.
This is where it all began.
I thought I told you not to come in here.
This? What is this? What have you done?
It's nothing to be concerned about. I'm merely indulging my curiosity. You, however, become something far greater.
He was smiling as he spoke, like a child playing with a doll.
Good morning. And how are we doing today, my dear children? You should celebrate, for today we are entering a new phase of our research. Rejoice on this glorious day of reunion. Praise curiosity and the progress it brings. For you are about to climb the ladder of evolution.
He was well known and celebrated as a scientific genius. But he used orphans like us as guinea pigs for his twisted experiments, then sold us all into slavery as enhanced soldiers.
How awful.
He always told us, humanity is but a stepping stone to the future, and curiosity is the philosopher's stone of evolution. His experiments never ended. He used my friends over and over again, like they were just objects. Mido, you bastard. I'll make you pay for what you've done.
Nothing is more important than preparedness.
I brought you something from the shelter. Provisions that you might be able to use.
I want to help. Can you give me... Who knows what kind of taste trips over... Oh, this stuff's... This is quite... I'll find something. Make sure you're ready for whatever comes.
Thanks to every... Make sure you've got everything before you go out.
I've got all... Siri. Watch yourself out there.
I still have the Relic of the Throat, the first one I received. But Mido took all the... I'll join you in the search when I can.
Nicola, thanks. I have a debt you may tell because... Things like this used to be common, huh? Thank you. Things like this used to... This makes me feel nostalgic somehow. Really got to get stronger now.
So that does. However, I think let's find that if the rep we have. I'm grateful to accept. Where did you get this? Can I really have- Yakumo suggested I read it, so I gave it a try. I didn't think I'd get to see how the story continues. I'm grateful to accept- I guess I'll take that. The fighting will get more in-
I feel- This is all we've got for available routes. Don't let the Lost make a meal out of you.
You have returned. Is this... Was I of any... You... Memory... The power... Is this...
Damn it, thieving bitch. Where did she go? She has her blood beads. She couldn't have gotten far. Keep searching!
Should we really be doing this?
What else can we do?
It's the only way we can get any blood beads. Okay, let's get out of here while we can. This is the last of the blood beads we worked so hard for. All of the blood springs around here have run dry. I couldn't get so much as a single bead from them. I'll need to do something soon.
I'm really sorry to make you do all the scary stuff, Mia. I wish I could help you fight.
Come on, Nicola. Stop worrying about things like that, alright? As long as you're safe, I'm happy to take care of everything else.
Who are you two?
Please, I know it's a lot to ask, but could you spare some blood beads? We don't have much time left.
I can see that loss is starting to set in. You really think you can fight in that condition?
Well, I won't know unless I try, right?
Come with me. I know a place where there are blood beads.
Most of the blood springs were already dry by the time I became a Revenant. Blood beads were difficult to come by, even in the best of circumstances. It was all we could do to survive. That was when we met Carmilla. We soon saw it wasn't us she was helping. She squeezed everything she could from us. In this world, you can never trust a stranger. That's what she taught me.
You have returned.
This is my home. I'm the only one who lives here now, so make yourselves comfortable.
Thank you.
You can call me Carmilla. And just remember, you're going to be working for me from now on. With that in mind, you're skilled at separating others from their blood beads, correct?
You helped us even though you knew?
I helped you because it was practical for me. So long as I have you two around, I won't need to risk my own neck. Why else did you think I would bother taking you in?
You always lived alone, Carmilla?
The past really doesn't matter, does it? You've got bigger things to worry about, like the laundry.
I'm sorry. I'm doing it.
Did everyone run away from you for being so selfish?
Being nice doesn't do you any favors. When it comes down to it, everyone looks out for number one. You would do well to remember that.
Trouble. The Lost are swarming out there. Huh? Where's Carmilla?
I saw her leave a little while ago. She must have caught wind of them and took off.
We need to run, Nicola. Get the blood beads from storage. But those belong to Carmilla.
You remember what she said. Being nice doesn't do you any favors.
Now hurry up, Nicola.
was how it all began. From that moment onward, we lived our lives completely on our own, without any help from others. There was a part of me that wanted to trust Carmilla. She was cold and standoffish, but that didn't mean she was a bad person. I thought maybe she was just awkward with people. But I was wrong. In this world, you can only rely on your own strength. No one out there is going to save you. I learned that lesson all too well. That's why meeting you guys was such a big shock for me. You were willing to reach out to me, a complete stranger, like it was no big deal. Spending time with all of you made me realize something. It's true that being nice might not do you any favors in the end. But that's what you need to do if you want to live a fulfilling life. But when I think of it, the reason that we lived the way we did before we met you was because of everything that happened back then with Carmilla. But you know, after she took off, I never did see her again. I wonder what ended up happening to her.